Joanna Lamond Lumley, OBEFRGS, is an English actress, voiceover artist, former model, author and activist, who starred in the British television series Absolutely Fabulous as Adina Monsoon's best friend, Patsy Stone, as well as in The New Avengers, Sapphire and Steel, Jam and Jerusalem and Sensitive Skin. In film she has appeared in On Her Majesty's Secret Service, Trail of the Pink Panther, and James and the Giant Peach. She later appeared in Maybe Baby, Ella Enchanted, and Corpse Bride. She appeared alongside Leonardo DiCaprio in the Martin Scorsese crime drama The Wolf of Wall Street. She has also appeared in several stage roles and in 2011 was nominated for the Tony Award for Best Featured Actress in a Play for her performance in La Bette. She has spoken out as a human rights activist for Survival International and the Gurkha Justice Campaign and is now considered a national treasure in Nepal because of her support. She is an advocate for a number of charities and animal welfare groups such as Compassion in World Farming and Vegetarians International Voice for Animals. She is patron of the Farm Animal Sanctuary. She also won the Special Recognition Award at the National Television Awards in 2013. As of July 2012, update, she is planning, in collaboration with the designer Thomas Heatherwick, a pedestrian bridge across the Thames in London. Garden Bridge. This is planned to feature trees and gardens. Early life. Joanna Lamond Lumley was born on 1 May 1946 in Srinagar, Kashmir and Jammu to English parents. Her father was Major James Rutherford Lumley, who served in the 6th Gurkha Rifles, a regiment of the British Indian Army, and her mother Thyra Beatrice Rose. They married in 1941. Lumley was raised in Kent, England, where she attended Micheldine School in Rovenden as a boarder. The family spent time in Hong Kong and Malaya. Lumley was educated at St. Mary's Convent School in Hastings, Sussex, and afterwards attended the Lucy Clayton Finishing School. After being turned down by the Royal Academy of Dramatic Art at the age of 16, career. Lumley spent 3 years as a photographic model, notably for Brian Duffy, by whom she was photographed with her son. She also worked as a house model for Jean Muir. Over 40 years later, she participated in another photo shoot, again with her son, for Duffy as part of a retrospective of the photographer's work. Lumley appeared in an early episode of the Bruce Forsyth Show in 1966. She appeared in a British television advertisement for Nimble Bread, first screened in 1969. Lumley did not receive any formal training at drama school. Her acting career began in 1969 with a small role in the film Some Girls Do, and as a Bond girl in On Her Majesty's Secret Service, in which she had two lines as the sole English girl among the villainous Hans Stavro Blofeld's Angels of Death. Lumley went on to have a brief but memorable role in Coronation Street, in which her character turned down Ken Barlow's offer of marriage. In 1973, she made another big screen appearance as Jessica Van Helsing in The Satanic Rites of Dracula, the last Hammer Dracula film to star Christopher Lee. She has worked with Tim Burton on two film projects, in James and the Giant Peach and Corpse Bride. She has also appeared alongside Hugh Laurie in the British romantic comedy Maybe Baby and alongside Anne Hathaway in Ella Enchanted. She has appeared twice in Agatha Christie's Marple, in the episodes The Body in the Library and The Mirror Are Cracked from Side to Side. In 2010, she appeared in a 4-episode guest arc on the BBC drama Mistresses as Vivian Roden. In 2013, she appeared in the Martin Scorsese crime drama The Wolf of Wall Street. Major roles throughout her career. She has specialized in playing upper-class parts, and her distinctive voice has reinforced this. Lumley's first major role was as Purdy in The New Avengers, a revival of the Secret Agent series The Avengers. Although critical reaction to the series was lukewarm, the casting of Lumley was seen as inspired and following the tradition of Avengers actresses Ono Blackman, Diana Rigg and Linda Thorson. In 1979 she appeared in another series which acquired a cult following, Sapphire and Steel, with David McCallum. Conceived as ITV's answer to Doctor Who, Lumley played a mysterious elemental being who, with her collaborator, Steel, dealt with breaches in the fabric of time. Over a decade later, Lumley's career was boosted by her portrayal of the louche, selfish and frequently drunk fashion director Patsy Stone, companion to Jennifer Saunders' Adina Monsoon in the BBC comedy television series Absolutely Fabulous, and in 1994 and 1995 Lumley starred alongside Nadine Garner and John Bow in the British television show Class Act, playing the part of Kate Swift, an upper-class lady who had fallen on hard times. Other work has included Lovejoy as widow Victoria Cavero in The Kingdom of the Thunder Dragon, a film about a journey made by her grandparents in Bhutan, and A Rather English Marriage in Dr. Willoughby. In 1995, she provided the voice of Annie the Rag Doll in the animated series The Forgotten Toys. In 1999, she also provided the voice for Sims the Chicken in the BAFTA award-winning animated series The Fox Busters. In 2000, she co-produced a new drama series The Cazales. She appeared in a TV series on Sarawak, where she spent time in her childhood. She has demonstrated her ability to go beyond stereotypical images, most notably in the monologue series of Playlets Up in Town, written by Hugo Blick, and focusing on a society hostess's realization that her star is fading. Lumley starred as the elderly Delilah Stagg in the 2006 sitcom Jam and Jerusalem with Dawn French, Jennifer Saunders and Sue Johnston. In July 2007, she starred in the second series of the drama Sensitive Skin, where she played the main character Davina Jackson. The BBC said this will be the final series of the dark comedy. She starred in David Herson's La Bette Comedy Theatre, London, the 26th of June, the 28th of August 2010 with David Hyde Pierce and Mark Rylance, directed by Matthew Walkus. She also starred in La Bette at the Music Box Theatre, Broadway, New York, which opened on the 14th of October 2010. She was nominated for the Tony Award for Best Featured Actress in a Play for her performance, Media Work. As the possessor of one of the most recognized voices in the UK, Lumley has gained prominence as a voiceover artist. Users of AOL in the United Kingdom are familiar with Joanna Lumley's voice. She recorded the greetings, "Welcome to AOL," and "You have email," and "Goodbye," for that company. She did a voiceover for the BBC series Posh Nosh as a voiceover, usually saying, "From the Posh Nosh range." She appeared as a guest host on Channel 4's The Friday Night Project, which aired on 3 August 2007. From 2005 to 2006, she appeared in adverts for insurance brokers Privilege. Lumley has also appeared on the last run of ITV's Parkinson as a guest on 27 October 2007, discussing the subject of young girls across the UK and how they need to behave better if they hope to be successful. She was asked to write the introduction to a re-edition in November 2007 of the book called The Magic Key to Charm, written by the pioneering female journalist Eileen Ashcroft. This is a book of tips to women, first written by Ashcroft in 1938 about how to be glamorous. I thought it was absolutely enchanting. It's how young women were told how to behave in the old days, and I think it might be just coming back for a bit of a revival, she explained in the interview. Because, I have to say, I adore our young ones and I think we have got some of the prettiest and loveliest girls in the world, but I think sometimes the behavior gets a bit bad and I think the girls let themselves down. They are so pretty and so lovely, but they should behave better, I think, then they will be more successful. In 1999 she appeared in the comic relief Doctor Who parody The Curse of Fatal Death as the final incarnation of the Doctor. She also appeared with Jennifer Saunders. Dawn French and Sienna Miller in The French and Saunders Pastiche of Mamma Mia for Comic Relief 2009, in which she played the role of Tanya. In 2004, Lumley appeared as the woman with the Sydney Opera House head in Dirk Maggs's long-awaited radio adaptation of the third book of the Douglas Adams series The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. In 2005, she published her autobiography, No Room for Secrets, which was serialized by The Times, for which she was once a regular contributor. In September and December 2008 and April of 2009, the BBC aired Joanna Lumley in The Land of the Northern Lights, a documentary about her search to see the Northern Lights in northern Norway. In May 2009, she supported the Green Party during the 2009 European elections campaign. For Lumley, the work of Green MEPs in the European Parliament in pursuing human rights and animal rights made the Green Party the obvious choice, and urged UK voters to cast a positive vote for a better future by voting Green in the European elections. Lumley also appeared in Literature to support changing the British electoral system from first-past-the-post to alternative vote for electing members of Parliament to the House of Commons in the alternative vote referendum in 2011. In 2009, she portrayed a rock star, believed to be dead for 35 years, but more predominantly, her twin, in the Counterculture Blues episode of the British television mystery series Lewis. In 2010, she donated £1,000 to Caroline Lucas's campaign to become the first Green MP during the 2010 general election campaign. In 2011, Lumley appeared in Uptown Downstairs Abbey, the comic relief parody of the critically acclaimed historical television dramas Downton Abbey and Upstairs Downstairs, playing herself and the character of Mrs. Danvers. She starred alongside Jennifer Saunders, Kim Cattrall, Victoria Wood, Harry Enfield, Patrick Barlow, Dale Winton, Olivia Colman, Tim Vine, Simon Callio, Michael Gambon and Harry Hill. In recent years, Lumley has worked extensively with ITV, and in 2010 Lumley was executive producer and presenter of Joanna Lumley's Nile, where she journeys up the River Nile from sea to source in Rwanda, for ITV. This was broadcast in four parts on ITV beginning on 12 April 2010, and repeated in June 2013. Lumley travelled again for ITV in 2011, this time visiting Greece for a four-part series titled Joanna Lumley's Greek Odyssey. The series aired on ITV beginning on 13 October. Once again, in 2012, Lumley travelled for ITV, now in search of Noah's Ark. The trip that encompassed three continents and also involved adventurously venturing into Iran will air in late 2012 as a single 90-minute documentary titled Joanna Lumley's Ark. In March 2014, she appeared in a BBC one-hour-long documentary featuring American musician Will.i.am. The program was called Joanna Lumley Meets Will.i.am. In December 2014, she presented Bette Midler, One Night Only, a one-off ITV special. In 2015, she presented a three-part factual series for ITV called Joanna Lumley's Trans-Siberian Adventure. The series saw Lumley travel 6,400 miles from Hong Kong to Moscow, along the Trans-Siberian Railway. In August 2015, Lumley backs children's fairy tales app Giving Tales in aid of UNICEF together with Sir Roger Moore, Stephen Fry, Ewan McGregor, Dame Joan Collins, Sir Michael Caine and David Walliams. Activism. As an activist, Lumley is best known for her support for Gurkhas, the exiled Tibetan people, and government, the Khanda Indigenous People of India and the Prospect Burma charity, which offers grants to Burmese students, for whom she broadcast a BBC Radio 4 charity appeal in 2001. Her father was a decorated Gurkha officer who fought in World War II Gurkha Justice Campaign in 2008. Lumley became the public face of a campaign to provide all Nepalese origin Gurkha veterans who served in the British Army before 1997 the right to settle in Britain. Those serving after 1997 had already been granted permission, but the UK government has not extended the offer to all of the Gurkhas, who are natives of Nepal. They have served Britain for more than 200 years, with over 50,000 dying in service, and 13 have been awarded the Victoria Cross. On 20 November 2008, Lumley led a large all-party group including Gurkhas starting from Parliament Square to 10 Downing Street with a petition signed by 250,000 people. She supports the Gurkha Justice Campaign. On 24 April 2009, she stated that she was ashamed of the UK administration's decision to affix 5 criteria to the Gurkhas' right to settle in the UK. With the support of both opposition parties and Labour rebel MPs on 29 April 2009, a Liberal Democrat motion that all Gurkhas be offered an equal right of residence was passed, allowing Gurkhas who served before 1997 residence in the UK. Following the government defeat, the Minister for Immigration Phil Wallace announced that a further review would be completed by the middle of July. On 5 May 2009, Lumley said that she had received private assurances of support from a senior member of the royal family, and attended a meeting with British Prime Minister Gordon Brown at 10 Downing Street the following day. Afterwards, she described the meeting as extremely positive and praised Mr. Brown, saying, "I trust him, I rely on him, and I know that he has now taken this matter into his own hands, and so today is a very good day." However, on the day following the meeting with Brown, 5 Gurkha veterans who had applied for residency in the United Kingdom received letters telling them that their appeals had been rejected. Many saw this as a betrayal, despite the fact that for the letters to have been received the day after the meeting, they might have been sent before it. Ms. Lumley confronted Phil Wallace at the BBC Westminster studios about the issue, and after pursuing him around the studio, the pair held an impromptu press conference in which Wallace agreed to accept Gurkha Justice Campaign input in developing new guidelines by July while giving sympathetic treatment to Gurkhas not meeting the then current immigration guidelines before the development of new guidelines. Following a Commons Home Affairs Committee meeting in which talks were held between campaigners, the Ministry of Defence and the Home Office on 19 May, Gordon Brown announced to the House of Commons on 20 May that the Home Secretary Jackie Smith would make a statement on the issue the following day. Ms. Smith subsequently announced that all Gurkha veterans who had served 4 years or more in the British Army before 1997 would be allowed to settle in Britain. As a result of her campaigning skills, there were calls for Joanna Lumley to stand as a Member of Parliament at the forthcoming general election. However, she has dismissed the suggestion. In July 2009, Lumley went on a visit to Nepal. Upon her arrival at Tribhuvan International Airport, she was greeted by crowds of Gurkha supporters. Lumley said in a statement, "I feel so humbled by the fact I'm going to meet so many ex-Gurkhas and their families, and see where they are and how they live." Whilst there, Lumley was hailed "Daughter of Nepal" by the crowds of fans at the airport. In August 2010, Lumley teamed up with British food company Sherwood's to help develop a limited edition mango chutney with Kashmiri chili, an ingredient from her birthplace. Sherwood's will donate 10p from each jar sold to the Gurkha Welfare Trust. Work for Survival International. Lumley has long been a supporter of Survival International and the cause of Indigenous rights, and narrated Survival's documentary, Mine, Story of a Sacred Mountain. The film tells the story of the remote Dongriya Konda tribe in India and their battle to stop a vast bauxite mine from destroying their land and way of life. In defense of the Dongriya, she has said, "It greatly disturbs me that a British company will be responsible for the destruction of these wonderful people. I urge the public to support the Dongriya, who simply want to be allowed to live in peace." Unlike so many of India's rural poor, the Dongria actually live very well in the Niamgara hills. And it's a terrible irony that what Vedanta is proposing to do in the name of development will actually destroy this completely self-sufficient people. Lumley also contributed her writing for the book We Are One, a celebration of tribal peoples, released in October 2009 with profits going in support of survival. A collection of photographs, statements from tribal people and essays from international authors. The book explores the richness of the cultures of indigenous peoples around the world and the risks to their existence. In her essay for the book, Lumley speaks of the Dongria way of life and the threats they face in the name of corporate interests, and calls for action to stop such decisions. Patron of TREAD. Lumley has been a patron of the UK charity TREAD since 1993. TREAD is a charity which enables communities in Africa's drylands to fight poverty and become self-reliant, while improving the environment. Patron of PENHA. Joanna Lumley is also a patron of the Pastoral and Environmental Network in the Horn of Africa, or PENHA. PENHA is an international NGO, founded in 1989 and based on the commitment of professionals and development workers from the Horn of Africa to address issues of pastoral concerns. From a regional perspective, Lumley's commitment to support the pastoral communities of the Horn of Africa is of paramount importance to PENHA. Patron of Peter Pan Moutbray Trust. Lumley is patron of the Peter Pan Moutbray Trust. Moutbray was the favourite place for author J.M. Barrie to play as a child, and the house and gardens are said to have inspired Barrie to create Peter Pan. The trust is undertaking a £4 million fundraising project to renovate the Georgian house and gardens to operate as an educational and cultural centre for local schools and J.M. Barrie enthusiasts and scholars. Patron of Trust in Children. Joanna Lumley is patron of the UK charity Trust in Children, which aims to help children from poor backgrounds to access education and opportunities for non-academic development. Patron of Action on Addiction. Lumley was patron of Action on Addiction, a UK-based charity that works with people affected by drug and alcohol addiction, from 1999 to 2000. Patron of the Friends of Cats in Uni. Joanna Lumley has been patron of the Friends of Cats in Uni since it was established in 2003, a small charity based in Keyworth, Nottinghamshire, UK, which is enabling the village of Cats in Uni, north of Mombasa, near Kilifi, to be transformed into a self-sufficient wealth-creating community by focusing on facilitating community-led developments for healthcare, education, and agriculture. Influence. In February 2013, she was assessed as one of the 100 most powerful women in the United Kingdom by Woman's Hour on BBC Radio 4.